You're watching the explosive weekend debate with Bikrit Sweenvalian. Ladies and gentlemen, the fight for 288 assembly seats is certainly heating up, with just 10 days to go before Maharashtra casts its first vote. A day that saw the BJP and the Mahavikas Agadi release its poll promises also saw furtherance of a bitter fight between the ruling Mahayuti and the opposition Mahavikas Agadi. Home Minister Amit Shah, while building up on Prime Minister Modi's Ek Hai Toh Safe Hai narrative, accused the Congress of making attempts to cut the existing quota of SCs, STs and OBCs to give it to the Muslims. He made this remark in reference to the letter which revealed that a delegation of Ulema board submitted a letter regarding several such demands for the Muslim community to the Congress party. He then reiterated that there is no provision in the constitution to provide reservation on religious basis and the BJP stands in firm opposition to the same. The Home Minister also dared Uddhav Thackeray to get Rahul Gandhi to praise Veer Savarkar and Balasaheb Thackeray. But none of this went down well with the Mahavikas Agadi. In fact, we saw an equally aggressive response from the Congress today. On one hand, Maharashtra Congress Chief Nana Patole rejected Amit Shah's assertion that the Congress had in fact agreed to the Ulema Council's demands. On the other hand, Congress Chief Mallikarjun Kharge continued to target the BJP over the several slogans calling for Hindu unity and said that the BJP was doing a job of dividing the country in the name of caste and religion. But why have we seen the BJP make a renewed push seeking Hindu consolidation of votes in Maharashtra? Let's recap for you some of the demands put forth by the Ulema board in providing conditional support to the Mahavikas Agadi in order to mobilize the Muslim vote in the state. Number one, the Ulema board has urged the MVA to oppose the Waqf Amendment Bill and seek its repeal. The Ulema board has also requested the Maharashtra government allocate 1,000 crore rupees to the Maharashtra Waqf board. Number three, the board is calling for a 10% reservation for Muslims in the state. And the Ulema board also has sought a ban on the RSS upon the formation of the Mahavikas Agadi. This is just four such demands. The list is long, and so the BJP is seeing a pattern in how the MVA is looking at consolidating the Muslim vote. But does the BJP have proofs to substantiate these claims beyond this letter? Because the Congress most certainly has rejected going by any of these demands of the Ulema board. And who is really polarizing to win the Maharashtra fight? We take that up with our experts in just a bit, but here's the story so far.
उलेमाओं की एक संस्था ने मांग की कि माइनॉरिटी को आरक्षण दिया जाए और कांग्रेस के अध्यक्ष नाना पटोले जी ने इस मांग को स्वीकार करने का पत्र एक्नोलेजमेंट एक दिया है। मैं महाराष्ट्र की जनता को पूछना चाहता हूं, क्या कांग्रेस पार्टी के ये मंसूबे के साथ आप सहमत हैं? कटेंगे तो क्या है, कटेंगे? अरे पहले तो आप मनुस्मृति स्वीकार करके पहले ही समाज को बांट दिया है, पहले ही बांट दिया, अब फिर और बांटना चाहते हैं?
जब किसी प्रेस के मित्र ने वो संविधान की प्रति को खोल कर देखा तो पूरा कोरा था, एक अक्षर भी नहीं। इससे बड़ा अपमान भारत के संविधान का भारत की 76 साल की आजादी में कभी नहीं।
उनको अगर नहीं मिला ये किताब तो मेरे तरफ से आप उनको दीजिए और वो उनको बोलिए साहब इसमें लिखा हुआ है।
Let me quickly go across to our panelists joining us this evening on the explosive weekend debate. We have national spokesperson of the BJP, Shehzad Poonawala, along with Dr. Raju Wagmare, spokesperson of Shiv Sena. We also have Dr. Shaba Mohammed, national spokesperson of the Congress, along with the Clyde Crasto of the NCPSP. Thank you, gentlemen, and Shama for joining us this evening. A very important discussion indeed. The battle most certainly is heating up. My first question is to Shehzad, because all of yesterday we were talking about the Ulema Board's demand, so on and so forth. So I'll touch upon that in just a bit, Shehzad. But today the Congress, be it Nana Patole or Mallikarjun Kharge, the Congress chief, have come out to say, batenge to katenge, ek hai to safe hai, so on and so forth, being spoken of by the BJP so aggressively, is an attempt to divide the people of the country on basis of caste and religion. How would you respond?
Batenge to katenge, hum ek hai to safe hai, is sampradayik, is communal, but vote jihad said by the Samajwadi party leader Maryam Alam is secular. But it is secular to say that Muslims should get 10% reservation on religious grounds. It is completely secular for the Muslim Seva Sangh to say Iman ke aadhar par vote karo MVA ko, and not a word of condemnation comes out from the Congress party or the MVA. It is secular for the Congress party to say Ram Mandir Pran Pratishtha is nach gana. It is secular for the Congress party's ally to say Sanatan Samapt and Sanatan is Bimari. And just today, just now, Mr. Kharge has said Gerua pehenne wale, that Gerua is Bhagwa. Bhagwa pehenne wale rajniti mein kyu aate hain? They should be out of politics. Now I ask Sama Mohammed, that can they say the same thing about Maulana? Can they say the same thing about Maulvi? And let me give some proof, because she will say I'm saying a wrong statement.
Mathadis aur mafia mein koi zyada fark nahi hota. Mathadis aur mafia mein koi zyada.
This is Akhilesh Yadav. Mathadis mafia mein fark nahi hota. Maybe they can say madarsa aur Maulvi aur mafia mein koi zyada fark nahi hota. And let's say that they are not divisive. They are for unity. So let me ask three specific questions to Shamaji. The biggest thing of division is that the Samvidhan of Baba Saheb Ambedkar used to never apply in Jammu Kashmir. Today it is applying because removal of 370 has taken place. But Congress NCF supported the resolution on 370, which means Bato Bharat ko Jammu Kashmir se aur Samvidhan apply mat karo. First time the Arakshan was given to Valmiki Samaj in Jammu Kashmir, but they want the Valmiki Arakshan done away with because they have supported the resolution. And thirdly, AMU Jamia used to have the reservation for Dalit community till very long period of time, but Congress ended that reservation. Now the matter is in court. We are arguing for it. Officially, does the Congress party support the Dalit reservation in AMU? Yes or no? These three specific questions they should answer.
Okay, Shama Mohammed, please respond, because I've seen Shehzad Poonawala really stay away from the Ulema Board's demands. If we talk about those demands, then the story is amply clear. So please respond. If the BJP speaks of, Hindu consolidation of votes, it's divisive in nature. If the same is being done by the Mahavikas Agadi or the INDI bloc in Maharashtra or rest of the country, it's an absolutely secular cause.
First and foremost, I'm not going to reply to Shehzad Poonawala. I'm going to reply to you. You're the anchor, and I have no business to reply to somebody like him. Now, the question arises, who is dividing the nation? Now, for me, Prime Minister Modi is also my Prime Minister, just like he's yours and everybody else's. But during the Lok Sabha elections, what did I hear? I heard him saying that Congress party is taking behest, the cow of the Hindus and giving it to Muslims. They're taking the Mangal Sutra of the Hindus and giving it to the Muslims. Guspetia coming here, they give birth to 7 children and they're going to take away all your wealth. I mean, this is the Prime Minister of India speaking. Not my leader has never spoken of divide and rule, whether it is Kharge ji, yeah, it is Rahul Gandhi ji. So we do not speak the language. This is the language spoken by the Prime Minister of India. He also said that if the Congress party comes back to power, tala lagayenge to all the mandirs. I mean, mandirs, I have huge respect. They've been existing for years in our country. We have all lived, different people. You are from a certain part of the country. I'm from another part of the country. You belong to another religion. I belong. And we have all, before 2014, we didn't have these issues. Now, which is always they fight politics based on religion. I just want to ask a simple question. He talks about Viksit Bharat, Amrit Kal. Now, why don't you talk about the development you've done in Maharashtra for the last 4 years when you captured power from us? Why do you talk about other things. Now, during the Karnataka elections, you spoke about what we were giving as guarantees as revedis. Now, the same thing you have copied and you're doing it. Now, let me tell you one very important thing. In Mumbai, the Mahayukti government has increased the salaries of madrasa teachers. Now, can I ask you, that is not Tushtikaran. Let me ask you that. Now, if the Congress party has done, that is appeasement. But when they do it, it is helping out the madrasa teachers. Now, why do you say and do these things? You're giving sari, you have got the Ladli Behna scheme, you've given construction workers kits, you're giving other sops to farmers. Now, you have been there. I want to ask you, why is the unemployment rate so high? Why are farmers committing suicide every day? So if why don't you talk about what development you've done in Maharashtra in the last 4 years, and let's not talk about religion. Let's talk about your development. You speak about it because there is no development. And that is why they go back to divide and root politics, like katega to batega, batega to katega, you know, all these things. Very simple. My leader, Rahul Gandhi, has always held the constitution. I have seen it, what is inside the constitution. And they keep talking about guspetias every time. Now, border security force is with the government of India. And the government of India, the home minister is Mr. Amit Shah. So I don't want guspetias coming into this country. I would like only Indians living. I don't want illegal immigrants. Now, I want Amit Shah to stop it. We can't. We are not in the government. When we were in the government, we'll try our best. You're in the government. Look at what's happening in J&K. Every day, terrorists are killing civilians and our jawans. Can he answer to that?
Okay, so you're saying several INDIA leaders may have been of the opinion that we need to give a certain reservation to the Muslim community, be it Lalu Prasad Yadav, be it S.K. Hassan from the Samajwadi Party. But what explains the Mahayuti? Shama, let me complete. I'm posing the question to Shehzad. But Shama Mohammad asks Shehzad, why is it then the Mahayuti decides to give a certain salary or increase the salary of madrasa teachers? Why is it only looked at with, you know, a lens wherein the Mahayuti is never ever accused of appeasement and only the Mahavikas Agadi is held responsible for the same? Shehzad. And I then need to go across to the others, please.
First of all, it's so ironical that when I posed a series of legitimate questions on Jammu Kashmir, on 370, on AMU, she skirted those issues and she started asking me questions. Perhaps that is how Sayyids and Ashrafs think towards Pasmanda, that Pasmanda should only answer, Pasmanda should never get a chance to ask a question. That's okay, I understand the elitist mindset.
I'll come to one by one the questions. I don't even know what Sayyids and Anwars and Pashmanda.
That I know you don't know. The depth of your knowledge is like Rahul Gandhi.
That is what you are.
Sushmi, can we please speak one by one?
We're not going to be able to reach any conclusion. Shama, Shehzad, please. It's a request, humble request to the both of you. Shehzad, please make your point. Shama, I'll come back to you in just a bit. Shehzad.
Look at what he's talking about. I mean, how dare he say something like this?
That's why, Shama, I am asking the both of you to refrain from making any personal comments. Let's please stick to facts. Let's please use this time to make legitimate arguments. Shehzad, please make your point.
Look, Krithveen,
you have to allow people to speak in their own turn.
Go ahead, Shehzad. Go ahead.
I did not interrupt. The basic courtesy and decorum is that even if we find somebody intolerable, we hear the other side. That's the basic we can do in a debate. By the way, you talk about castes and Hindus all the time, but one time a Pasmanda talks about his status, then the people who are in the upper class get affected. Now, let me make my point one by one, Krithveen, and I'll take 30 seconds. She spoke about Bhais and Mangal Sutra. In Karnataka, Vijayapura, the farmers' lands were taken and given to the Waqf. It happened. Secondly, Guspetia has not been spoken by BJP. The Jharkhand High Court has said Guspetias are coming in, and it is the Jharkhand Sarkar that did nothing. From the last 10 years, not a single Guspetia could come in because we have strengthened the border infrastructure. But you are the ones who 10 years before that allowed these Guspetias to become citizens of this country and get even the documents. Thirdly, I am saying that today the statements made on development, right? You want development? I'll tell you 10 parameters on development. You please tell me what you have done on development. 7 crore people have been given the Garib Kalyan Yojana. 51 lakh LPG cylinders, 71 lakh toilets, 15 lakh households got bijli, 1 crore people in the farm sector got Kisan Samman Nidhi, 3.5 crore accounts, 2.5 crore sisters got the Ladli Behna Yojana. You tell me how many women got 1500 rupees in Himachal? or you tell me what you have done in 2.5 years. And last point, Krishwin, I just have one question to ask. Who raises Samvidhan issue on every platform? Rahul Gandhi. Samvidhan should be applied in Jammu Kashmir? Absolutely, yes. What is 370? It means that there should be different Samvidhan. So now, how is it illegitimate for me to ask Shama
Mohammad? But the concern, Shehzad, which is being raised by the opposition here is, from vote jihad, from the term vote jihad used by Devendra Fadnavis back in October, I think it was first week of October, sometime around that, he first spoke of that concept and attributed it to the BJP result in the state of Maharashtra. To now, the Prime Minister or Yogi Adityanath or any BJP leader for that matter saying, batenge to katenge, is this not being seen as an attempt to polarize? That's the question that the opposition is asking. Where are the facts in what you're saying or alleging with regards to the Ulema board? Where are the facts here?
Where is the evidence? Simply, he cannot
I've put that question out, Shama. Let him respond. Shehzad.
Thank you, Krishwin. Krishwin, the statement of batenge to katenge and ek rahenge to safe rahenge, which was started by Yogi Adityanath ji, in that same speech, and I'm challenging you, play the entire speech, he has said that Bangladesh mein dekho jo sthitiyan ban rahi hai, agar wahan bate hai, to wahan kate, is it not a fact? Is it not a fact ki jab Sikh bate the to 84 mein kate the? Is it not a fact that jab partition hua 47 mein jab bate to kate? Krishwin, can I please not be disturbed? What is the problem?
Okay, okay. Go ahead. No, we will. Others need to come in as well.
But why is he interrupting?
My limited question is on vote jihad. Because that seems to be taking shape in a different way and form as far as the BJP campaign is concerned.
Krishwin, please allow me the time to answer. When I answer, they are interrupting. So you stop them from interrupting, so my answers will be complete. I am answering your question. The context of the batenge to katenge, ek rahenge to safe rahenge, is what is happening to Hindus in Canada, what is happening to Hindus in Bangladesh. But you have a bunch of people who will put 72 ट्वीट डालेंगे मुसलमानों के लिए गाजा में, पर इनके मुंह से एक शब्द हिंदुओं के लिए नहीं निकलेगा बांग्लादेश में. राहुल गांधी बोला क्या हिंदुओं पर? नहीं बोले ना. क्यों नहीं बोले? राहुल गांधी को इतना दुख होता है गाजा के मुसलमानों का, पर एक समस्या उनको हिंदुओं की बांग्लादेश में नहीं दिखाई दी. ये मिस्टर कैस्ट्रो उनकी तरफ से आया कोई बयान? पैलेस्टाइन के मुसलमान को जोड़ना है, हिजबुल्ला को जोड़ना है, हमास को जोड़ना है, पर हिंदुओं के बारे में कुछ नहीं बोलेंगे?
अंडरस्टूड. आई टेक दैट फॉरवर्ड. आई नीड टू गो अक्रॉस टू अदर्स एज वेल. इंटरेस्टिंगली एंड दैट्स वेयर आई वांट टू गो अक्रॉस टू डॉक्टर राजू. मिस्टर क्रास्टो, आई विल कम बैक टू यू इन जस्ट अ बिट एंड आई विल गिव यू टाइम टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू व्हाटएवर शहजाद हैज सेड. बट डॉक्टर राजू वाघमारे, इंटरेस्टिंगली ऑफ द रिएक्शंस वी हैव पिक्ड अप सो फार from the Shiv Sena or from the Ajit Pawar faction of the NCP, none of them seem to be in support of the sloganeering which is being carried out by the Bharatiya Janata Party. What's your take on that?
See, you have to understand that why this slogan has came out. Okay. For that, you just look into the Lok Sabha result. I'll tell you about one constituency, Dhule. In that Dhule constituency, the total 6 Vidhan Sabha constituency come into that one parliamentary constituency. In 5 constituency, the BJP and Mahayuti was on leading position. One constituency open out of 1,98,000 votes, 1,96,000 votes belongs to Muslim community and they came to Congress. I can show you there are lot of constituencies where Muslim has 100% voted for Maha India, like India Gadbandhan. I'm not saying that they should vote whoever they want. Okay? But the vote came after the fake narrative has been set up by India and talking about that Muslim is khatre mein. The Muslim wants the BJP or Mahayuti will come into the power, there will be a lot of...
Okay, Dr. Raju Vagmari, you can perhaps correct me on these figures, but of what I've seen, of what I've gathered, 38 assembly constituencies, which have more than 20% Muslim population, in 20 of these, BJP and its allies increased their vote share in Lok Sabha elections, if we compare it to 2019.
No, you have to understand one thing. If you see that, because of fake narrative, if certain community you target Dalit, you target Muslim, and you start this fake narrative that the constitution is going to be changed if the BJP came. All Dalit, they voted for India. The same thing happened with the Muslim. When this kind of things are happening with the fake narratives, so to counter that, if the BJP says that Hindus should be get together the way the Muslim is getting together, then why?
And you think that's not divisive? You are saying this should be seen as part of BJP's election strategy and not an attempt to divide on the basis of caste.
No, it started, this attempt to divide the policy started by India, started by Congress. Congress started this, that the constitution is going to be changed. Now, if you tell me in Maharashtra assembly election, what is the relation to the constitution? Assembly relation can change the constitution. Assembly relation can talk about the constitution. What? That much brain Mr. Rahul Gandhi does not have? What kind of points that you are taking into the assembly constitution? You want to talk about development? I will talk about development. In last 2 years, we have done all the development which has been stopped by Mahavikas Aghadi. We started our Samruddhi, we started our Atal Setu, we started ample number of infrastructure projects, as well as we started the social welfare programs. So, if you want to development, we can talk about it.
Okay.
You guys does not did anything in last 2.5 years. So, Rahul Gandhi does not want to talk about it. Mr. Khadge doesn't want to talk about it. Who bring the constitution? They bring the constitution. And they started the division in Lok Sabha with this fake narrative. Now it's coming back to them, what they started, now they are crying.
Okay, Mr. Krastu, would you want to quickly respond? Shehzad had a couple of points to make. He wanted your response on the same.
Listen, you know what? I'll tell you what you do. Don't you do one thing? Why don't you do, Ms. Walia, one thing? You sit with Shehzad and do the anchoring. No, you don't seem to know
what
you're anchoring.
Sir, that would be so unfair. I've given everybody an equal opportunity. That's absolutely unfair. No, I will not take that lying low, Mr. Krastu. That's not fair. Anyway, sir, we have limited time. Let's please go ahead. These were questions posed to Shehzad Poonawalla. I was also very clearly not siding with him, so I don't know where you're coming from. But Mr. Krastu, please go ahead, make your point.
You're not to me.
Sir, go ahead, make your point. You're clearly not sticking to the debate line. Let's please carry on.
You're not sticking to the debate. You are going behind Shehzad Poonawalla. You are running behind Shehzad Poonawalla.
Okay, I think I can speak for the other panelists as well. And I don't think anybody agrees with you, Mr. Krastu. Let's hold this debate in a civil manner. Let's not do this.
No.
Mr. Krastu, do you want to respond to my question, sir?
So you ask me the question. Don't tell me what Shehzad is asking.
Okay, all right. My question to you is that everybody on the panel who's opposing the Mahavikas Aghadi is saying that these were false narratives being spoken of by the Congress, by the Mahavikas Aghadi, by the INDI block leaders. And so the BJP is only coming out with a counter strategy to the same.
The BJP is known to play divisive politics all the time. Mr. Amit Shah will come, the Honorable Prime Minister will come to Maharashtra during elections and talk about divisive politics. We have to unite as a country. They're talking about Hindus have to unite. We all have to unite. Every Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, everybody has to unite and work together for the country. Only during elections they come to think of it. Now my friend, my really good friend Raju Vagmare was talking about development and he was opposing. For 2.5 years when he was with us, he was talking against the BJP. Now he's on the other side, he's talking the opposite. Doesn't work. The point here is Mr. Ajit Pawar himself has said, "Buttenge to cuttenge," that narrative will not work in India. I think Mr. Raju Vagmare has not heard that. Their own Mahayuti leader has said that these narratives will not work in Maharashtra. People of Maharashtra have already rejected the Mahayuti during the Lok Sabha elections. They will reject them further again. So all these narratives will not work at all.
And as has been spoken of by experts
as well, Dr. Vagmare, that none of that has worked to the BJP's advantage in the Lok Sabha elections. coming back to you, Shama, I'm coming to you in 30 seconds. Let Dr. Raju respond.
See, the one more thing you have to understand, that in Lok Sabha, they never talk about development. Now, in assembly also, they are not talking about development. We are ready to fight on development. We are fighting this election with Mr. Eknath Shinde, our chief minister and our leader, who has taken in 2 years so many decisions, so many good infrastructure projects, so many social welfare projects, that none of the chief minister has been taken in Maharashtra. We bring Maharashtra in number one position in FDI. We bring Maharashtra in social welfare program. We are the number one state in whole India in infrastructure projects. Why it came in last 2 years? So we are talking about development.
Okay.
We are not going into the polarization.
Okay.
The polarization and the division bring by Congress. Congress does not have anything to talk. So Congress coming with the constitution. An assembly election. State does not have any right to do anything.
The fear is, Dr. Raju Vagbare, the fear is that there is a sense that the voter feels that an attempt is being made to create fear in their minds that they have to now vote on communal lines, and that's the only point that I'm trying to stick to. But Shama, to quickly talk about how there are those who are in the opposition who've not quite been able to restore that kind of faith when it comes to Rahul Gandhi and his kind of politics, because the likes of Mayawati, in fact, for instance, have said that Rahul Gandhi makes misleading statements on reservation policies. He's failed to pass, rather the party's failed to pass SCST reservation bill during its tenure. And most importantly, what she said was that he addresses issues of, marginal communities when out of power, else the Congress party only acts against their interest. So that's why there are those who've really not believed in the narrative that the Congress has been trying to work on the last 4-5 years.
So Mayawati did not even get the Dalit votes during the Lok Sabha elections. That's all I have to tell
about. And yet she didn't want to be a part of the INDI bloc.
So I can just tell that. She didn't even guess. Yeah, she was not part. She should have got the votes. She's a Dalit leader. Why didn't she ask her, why haven't you got the Dalit votes? She's supposed to get that. That also was consolidated in the India Alliance. So we understand where she stands. Let me give the answer to that. Now, this doctor person who's been talking from Shinde faction, I've understood one thing. He abhors and hates the Constitution of India because he doesn't like us talking about the Constitution of India.
What's
spoken about the Constitution
us?
About India.
Dr.
Raju Vagbare, please let her complete. Let her complete and then I'll try coming to you because I don't have time. I'm running out of time. Let her please complete her point.
Deputy CM of Rajasthan
because we are talking about facts. Your Rahul Gandhi hates constitution.
It is not us. Dr. Vagbare, it's a humble request. Please don't speak over one another. We're not being able to understand a thing. Shama, so I'm running out of time quickly.
Yes. CM of Rajasthan, Diya Kumari, who herself said that, after we cross 400 par, we will change the constitution. It is not the Congress leaders. Arun Govil also said that they are going to change the constitution.
Really?
He's a member of parliament for the Bharatiya Janata Party. And my leader Rahul Gandhi has condemned what has happened in
Bangladesh.
Okay, so let's agree to the fact that the 400 par slogan has backfired for the BJP. Running out of time needs a 30-second response. 30-second response from Shehzad Poonawalla, since I'm running out of time. Shama Mohammad, I agree to the fact that the 400 par slogan has indeed backfired for the BJP. And yes, that point was made by a few BJP leaders much before they realized that it's not working out for them. But I want to hear from Shehzad Poonawalla.
How can you go on to somebody else when I've not finished my point? You didn't allow me to speak.
Okay, 30 seconds to him and I need to quickly wrap up. Shama, I'm really running out of time.
What I'm saying is that we have always condemned when a temple, anything has happened in Bangladesh, my leader has condemned. I even have condemned what has happened in Bangladesh, even what has happened in Canada. See, every place of worship has to be kept safe, as that is what the Congress party is.
May I speak, Kritsveen, it's my turn.
Shama, I'm afraid that's all the time I have for you, and I'm not going to be able to hear it from him. So I have literally 15 seconds for Shehzad. Let him respond to you. Shehzad.
Kritsveen, I want to give the remainder of my time to Shama with just one question. She loves the constitution, right? Why should it not be implemented in Jammu Kashmir? Why are they supporting the 370 resolution? Answer, Shama. Take the time.
To be fair, they've remained relatively silent on the 370 issue. In fact, as far as Congress manifesto is concerned, that didn't even find a mention in Jammu and Kashmir, the 370 issue. But that's all the time I have. Apologies to those I couldn't come for. Thank you for joining us this evening. While talking about Maharashtra, the state PWD minister, Ravindra Chauhan, reached out to voters ahead of the 2024 Maharashtra elections, interacted with diverse communities in Dombivli. The Maharashtra minister, in fact, ensured infrastructure and urged public backing for his mission of Dombivli first. Let's quickly listen in.